Been waiting 9 months for this machine. It's finally here.
Explain more about the weight in a minute, but for now, let's go pick it up. Interesting. Got some friends coming. We're gonna try to get it down the hill and into the shop. So I'll see you in the shop. It just seems so tiny. I don't know what I was expecting. I mean, for 600 pounds, I just thought it would be a lot larger. From down here, it looks a lot bigger, doesn't it? I don't know. Maybe it's just like the short beds here. I'm sure I'll end up getting the extension at some point. Let me tell you about the little delay we had. Exactly 1 year ago today, I narrowed it down to about four or five different jointers. I believe it was the CWI 16 inch, this one, the Hammer 12 inch, Recon 12 inch, and the King Industrial 12 inch. Ended up pulling the trigger on the CWI 16 inch. It had a 3 month lead, which I was totally fine with. The issue was that 3 months turned into 4 months, 4 months to 7 months, 8 months, and I believe it ended on 9 months. I called them and I didn't get the warm fuzzies, so canceled the order and went back to the drawing board. So I mirrored it down to the SCM 12 inch and this guy, the Hammer 12 inch. And I really like that SCM. It's $1,000 more and he had a 3 month lead time. Whereas I lucked up with this guy, group in Canada here, actually had a whole whack load of them coming. So I was sold. I'm sick and tired of waiting around for a year. Okay, I think I'm happy with that. Let's do some unboxing. We've got the aluminum vents and a few different boxes that came with it. Shortage of cap tire, you get a yellow jacket. So nice extension cord. So this is it for assembly. Pretty straightforward. The instructions though, weren't the greatest. And I'm not too concerned about the assembly, but the calibration, that scares me a bit.
Try one.
Is it good?
Yep.
Whoa. Those are sour. Well, thank you, good boy.
Yeah.
I got the yellow plug here to carry on with the yellow theme. So there's a video on YouTube of a guy, actually in British Columbia, where we used to live, and he's got one of these Hammer units, but his tables are completely out of whack. I saw that when I was trying to decide between the SCM and this one, and it really scared me. But let's first see if this thing turns on, and then see what we're looking at. Hopefully mine's in decent shape. Okay, so I've got a 36 inch straight edge here with a tolerance of 3 thou. Bit of a dip on the back half of the infeed. Let's see if I can get 2 thou in there. 4, 5, no. So we've got 4 thou corner to corner, about 2, 3 front to back. Just barely squeaking 1 thou. You know, we're about 12 inches, so that's the tolerance of the straight edge. I think the outfeed though is more important. Let's check that guy out. There's 4, so there's a lot of friction on 5. Yeah, I don't know if you want to call that 4 or 5. So corner to corner, we got 6 thou, which, not the best. 7, no, it's pushing it up. Tight 3 right here, just in the middle. I don't know, I guess maybe call it 2. Trying to make myself feel better on this one. No buyer's remorse, but I'll show you the saw slot actually. This is 1 thou, barely squeaking in, getting 3 thou corner to corner. So it gives me something to reference off of. Looks like a hammer's lagging behind saw slot there, but comment down below, let me know. It's time for the scary part. That's actually calibrating. That's beautiful. I wish you could see my old 6 inch from 4 or 5 years ago. That was tough trying to clean that thing up, but it was like just a constant battle. As far as I remember, step 1 is getting the outfeed set to the cutter head. Need to get it just touching. Can you hear that? Pretty sure that is perfect. Seems a bit heavier. You can really hear that one. But I think we're good. I'm liking this so far. Okay, since I'm happy with the outfeed, now we move on to the infeed. As you probably know, the infeed moves up and down depending on how much you want to cut. So they're not in the same plane or you'd be cutting that thing, but they're cool plane. So I'm just gonna kind of cantilever this over the infeed and check to make sure this gap is exactly the same. Looks like we're not totally coplanar. I had 18 thou of a gap here, 20, and then a really tight 20 here, and that appears to also drop off the rear slightly. This is what you can expect if you receive yours and don't touch it. I think I'm gonna run a bunch of wood through it and just see how it performs, and then probably make some slight tweaks. You can check the fence on the jointer now, and then we'll test it out. I can just barely fit one little feeler, 1 thou, behind there. This is a lot easier to adjust. Nothing coming through here. Okay, I think it's about that time. I've never used a helical head. I'm quite excited. Check it out. It worked. Maybe I don't need to adjust it after all. I need to do some more testing. Actually, just before I move on to planing this guy, there is one thing I need to talk about. My 6 inch had the good old pork chop, and now I've got, what do we call this, Euro guard? Is that right? I'm really excited because now I get to film something. I think you'll know what I'm talking about when you see it. Let me get a bigger piece of wood. For some reason, whenever these Euroguard people pass their hands over it, it's like they're trying to dance or something. So it's like, you know what I'm talking about though? I think it's like if you have one of these guards, you're not allowed to just lift your hand from one side to the other. No, 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 you have to feel the guard. Let me try, okay. Here we go.
How do I do?
Did I do it? Did it look good? The method seemed to work. Board's nice and flat, straight. Okay, I'm gonna take my turn at edge jointing this. Well, I think in Blake, we even talked about how annoying this is. Well, it's because I don't want to talk about it. It is annoying. It does surprise me though that no one's thought of quicker or better way. It should be like a quick lever, just pops up. Not difficult. I have to learn millimeters. I think us Canadians use millimeters, but we don't unless we're really smart. Cross, I don't know, call it 10 inches. We are 2/3 of a difference. So that means the bed is just slightly skewed. Once again, let me know. Is that fine? Or should I go through the hassle of trying to correct that? I feel like a lot of these things, I would start adjusting it and it would take me the whole day. Okay, you guys are the greatest. That's a wrap for me. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.